Hey guys, we're gonna do a glitch. We're gonna actually go back to what I was talking about in the original Dragonfly Dojo part, and we're gonna try to glitch to get all three of these kites. I did fiddle around with this after we finished, was it? Thieves Den. And I'm back here to get some more lives, because I think this level has the most lives. And while I was messing around with it, I discovered that hovering like this, it's kind of hard to explain. You basically have to tap, you do the X button to glide. You tap A once, or X, and then press the hover button. Hover button and A simultaneously. So you don't accidentally do a, problem is I can't figure out, it just doesn't want to seem to work on this rock. We'll go to the second one next, but I can't seem to get this one. We might come back, we'll try to come back and try it again. As you can see here, I had the ice press, so we could do that. And I was trying to get over here using a method that I saw on YouTube by Pete the Player. You use this pillar here to give you some extra height when you're gliding. However, I can't seem to do that properly. I need more practice with that. Just wanted to say I'd done it, you know? I said in the original Let's Play I was pretty sure that when I was a kid I kind of thought there was a way to get up there, and it's buried deep in my mind that I theorize I actually was able to. Who knows if that was actually true, to be honest, I don't know. Going to the third rock, you'll see why that may have been a thought of mine. Anyway, I'm gonna go to the second one here. Whoop. We'll go to the second rock. Get on this one and just glide over. Long jump. Preparing you for the many long jumps ahead in the game. The whirlwind is not how you do it. Instead, you have to get on this right here. It's just tall enough so you can get over it. You have to do the hover technique I was showing off. Use that little leg on the rock to get up there. Whoa. There we go. Tap A, then to initiate a glide you tap A, but instead you tap Y at the same time. So you hold it down with your thumb. Tap A. Do that real quickly, and you can almost do it without gliding. It's just kind of it's kind of like an L cancel, if you will. I have nothing, no idea what Smash Brothers is like, but that's kind of. It's not related to shielding. In Smash Brothers, L canceling is related with falling, and then you can press the L button to get rid of some frames of delay there. You land, I think. That guy looks like Trippy from Star Fox Adventures. I think I already said that in some recording. I don't know if that'll make it in the video. Thieves Den, I think. That was part 21. The next rock, you can actually get without the ice breath at all. You don't need the ice breath. See what I'm talking about. There's like three vases or jars in this level with the butterflies in them. The Thieves Den kind of killed my life count. So there's the kite. We might be able to actually get to it from here. Yep, just glide onto it. Just to fool the player into thinking you don't need ice breath, but the rest... Just give them a taste of the fact that this can be...
I think grasshoppers are fun to play with, don't you?
No. New line of dialogue. We already got the, I can talk to all of them. Say this thing. Okay, I'm gonna have to go around and see what else they say, because they say stuff once you've done the mission already. Let's go back to... I'm gonna teleport back over through the magic of editing to the other stone. I'm trying to get that done. RJ?
Hi, Spyro. If you see Jackie, tell him that I just thunk up a good game we can play with grasshoppers. Oh, don't tell Steffi, though. I don't think she'd like it. It's called Hopper Splat. Sounds fun, huh?
Like I said in the part where we help these guys, they may actually be... originally from Spyro 3, maybe. They have another baby dragon, oddly enough, in Monkey Monastery. Mandy, no. She, not Mandy, I don't know what her name was. It could have been Mandy. I don't know how to do this, really. Just really tricky. I'll try the hover trick again. It's possible I could have figured this out when I was younger, but someone had to eventually, you know, with the YouTube and stuff. If you glide into the rock, you'll fall. So it's better if you do it quickly enough, and it actually gives you more altitude. As you, if you see there, it's higher. If you do it, it can, you know, real quickly. Versus gliding a bit. Of course, you want to do that at the top of your jump. I'm trying. I still can't get up there with this technique. So you about have to. Pete the player also. He got up there with the hover. I can't do it. Maybe. I don't think it has anything to do with the GameCube version. That's the thing I blame when I can't do something. He was probably on the GameCube version, because that's the best version of the game. That happened before too. I guess I pressed the Z button somehow. I pressed so hard. Oh, and you realize how easily I cut up on the second rock, so. Yeah, I just can't do it. Maybe I'm doing it in the wrong place, perhaps. Is the controller whacked out or what? It's a programming issue. It's like somehow pressing these buttons opens the start menu. For the Atlas. That's just weird. See, I don't know what was that? Can't charge during this. Yes, I press so hard, I press through the button into another button. All right, let's go to the. Try a different technique here. But either way, the idea of using something to make your jump higher is what makes the glitch possible. Either it's the rock or this pillar here. Yeah, you know, it looks, as you can see, I don't know, it beats me, man. I don't know how it's even possible you can do this. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. Yeah, I didn't miss a dragonfly. I'll put that in. Or dragon, I didn't miss talking to the other dragon. Rusty, RJ, and probably Steffi. Yep. It's all be done. Maybe I'll get it. Using the lack of hard drive space to my advantage here as a timer. Okay, this is how much time you have. Time is running out, sir. Obviously, it's something you have to practice at.